Yeah, well, there he is, the man of the hour.
I'd like to thank all the little people. I couldn't have done it without them.
You know what? Seriously, you were really great. I mean, you rose to the occasion. Congratulations.
Thank you.
It's been a long journey to end up here, hasn't it?
And through it all, you were right there. My conscience, my moral support, and much more of a friend than I deserve.
You know what? You're right.
Have you seen Lois?
Not yet. But let's just remember, no matter what she says, she was blown away.
You think?
Yeah, I mean, she had to be. You were never better.
Good. Because I really believe that if I can convince her that I've reprioritized my life to put music and her first, that everything else will just fall into place.
Hi. A little crowding in here today.
Yeah, you know, I didn't think you'd mind. Lila had a lot of appointments, and Annabelle looked really lonely.
It's not the dog sitting in the chair I'm talking about.
All right, this has gone on long enough. Brenda, I'd like a few minutes alone with Lois.
Stuff it. I'm busy.
Yes, you are. With me, the artist. I need to speak to my manager. Brenda?
Ned, don't order me around.
Do you want me to go? Don't go far.
Okay.
Traffic over there, huh?
I think it's sink or swim time.
Well, it better be swim because I have a major investment riding on this.
The original romantic, huh?
Tell me something. What business survives with romantic fun in the show? At the same time, this particular business doesn't survive without romance, which those kids have in spades. That's what we need. You know what I'm saying? You know what I think? I think instead of bending McGill's ear on this Puerto Rico gig, I'm gonna just chill out, let the natural forces work. How about a brew, huh?
Coming up.
Oh.
Yes.
Sonny, I'm glad you stopped by. I'd like to ask you some questions.
Fire away.
What can you tell me about Frank Smith and Bradley Ward?
Not a thing. Way before my time.
Uh-huh.
Why the interest? You work on a case? It seems we have ourselves a stalemate here.
Maybe not. How about Frank Smith and Jack Bowen? Any bells go off there?
I'm afraid it's a very quiet night.
Why do I get the feeling that you could shed some light on this subject if you wanted to?
Because even if I tried, I would make a lot of people very unhappy. And that's definitely not in my best interest.
Not even in the cause of justice?
Well, that is a relative term at best. Sorry, Mac.
Yeah, I understand. But listen, if you change your mind, you know where to find me.
Yeah. Thanks for the brew, huh?
What about your investment?
I don't want to interrupt the flow, you know? Miguel needs Lily more than he needs me. Catch you later.
Hey.
Nurse said you're ready.
What's up?
Nothing. Am I crashing a party here?
No, I guess it's about time you guys met. Justus Ward, Sonny Corinthos.
How do you do, Mr. Corinthos?
I'm doing pretty well, Mr. Ward. How about yourself?
Oh, well, better every day, they tell me.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. I'm sure a lot of people in Port Charles will be happy to see you on your feet.
Are you included in that group?
Well, I tend to trust Luke's judgment.
So do I.
Well, if I do say so myself, you both show incredible insight and good taste in character.
heard some very interesting things about you from Luke.
And I've heard some very interesting things about you from Luke. Mr. Gossip Man here.
Well, I figure, you know, you round up the right people, you get the job done, huh?
Well, if the job means getting him elected, my presence here is a little compromising, don't you think?
Well, getting me elected is part of a long-range plan. But there are other things that take precedence. For instance, finding out what connection Frank Smith had to my father's murder.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that you may be of some help in that area. And I'd appreciate it.
Look, I'm happy to help you two find the truth. As long as I don't cut my throat in the process. I'm sure you appreciate that, right?
Can't get much information from a dead man.
Ain't that the truth, man? Meanwhile, I'm becoming very popular on the subject of our mutual friend. This room isn't wired, is it?
I did a sweep.
When highly paid PIs start asking me questions the way you two are, I tend to take extra precautions.
Who?
Max Scorpio. He wants to know the connection between Frank and Jack Boland.
Mac? Hired by who? Quartermain?
Guess so.
Edward's looking to find stuff on Jack and Frank to take the heat off himself?
That'd be my read. It fits with what his lawyer's been saying on TV.
I missed it.
Well, you know the tune. He's talking about politically motivated setup and, you know, Edward's business enemies.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wait, but it makes... there's a certain amount of logic to their reasoning. I mean, if you look at the four main players in the deal to stop my father and take into account that it was a homicide, which one of them steps up to the plate?
The cleanup hitman, Frank.